Important polyhalogen compounds. Polyhalogen compounds. Polyhalogen compounds. Examples for polyhalogen compounds is dichloromethane. It has two halogen atoms known as dichloromethane. Dichloromethane, commonly known as DCM, it can act as a good nonpolar solvent. Second one, chloroform. Chloroform, it is a good organic solvent as well as mainly used in anesthesia in surgeries. Chloroform. Third one is carbon tetrachloride. Then okay, fluoro, dichloro, ethane. Okay, so these are the dichloro, difluoro, ethene, dichloro, difluoro, ethene. Okay, so these are the some of the polyhalogen compounds. Properties. Properties of alkyl halides. Due to higher electronegativity of halogen atom, it always withdraw the electrons from carbon. So therefore carbon always carries which charge? Positive charge. Due to positive nature of carbon, these are easily react with nucleophiles. So that is the reason why alkyl halides are mainly undergoes nucleophilic substitution reactions. Which reactions? Nucleophilic substitution reactions. Now this is RL react with Nu minus. The Nu minus is coming nucleophile. L means living group. Which group? Living group. So that is the reason why it is what? RNU. RNU plus loss of which one? Living group. So this is known as a nucleophile. This is known as substrate. Substrate, nucleophile or reagent. This is known as living group. Living group. This is known as what? Product. For example, here is Br. This is alkyl bromide. Due to higher electronegativity of bromine, it withdraw the electron towards bromine. So therefore, so now the Br minus can act as a leaving group from the substrate molecule to form a carbocation. Carbon carries which charge? Positive charge. This positive charge species is reacted by any one of the nucleophile to form which one? NU. To form which one? NU minus. Okay, so that is the reason why alkyl halides mainly undergoes which type of reactions? Nucleophilic substitution reactions. Means one nucleophile is replaced by another nucleophile. One nucleophile is replaced by another nucleophile in a substitution reaction. Alkyl halides mainly undergoes which reactions? Nucleophilic substitution reactions. Nucleophilic substitution reactions. Nucleophilic substitution reactions. Nucleophilic substitution reactions. An alkyl chloride react with a base. Base can act as a nucleophile. Cl minus can act as a leaving group. Loss of Cl minus takes place to form which one? ROH. So an alkyl halides react with aqueous potassium hydroxide to form an alcohol. So it is an example of which reaction? Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Which reaction? Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now, nucleophilic substitution reaction based on molecularity, based on molecularity, based on molecularity, the nucleophilic substitution reactions are classified into three types. Especially two types we will discuss right now. One is unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Second one is bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Based on molecularity, these are divided into two types. One is unimolecular SN1. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. SN2 reaction means bimolecular nucleophilic substitution. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution and bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Based on order and molecularity, the nucleophilic substitution reactions are classified into two types. In that, the first one is SN1 reaction. Which reaction? SN1 reaction. SN1 reaction. In unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, in unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions, tertiary alkyl bromide. So first, loss of Br minus takes place. This particular step is known as slow step or rate determining step. According to chemical kinetics, the number of substrate molecules participate in slow step or rate determining step. Rate of the reaction depends on that particular substrate rate. React with sodium hydroxide to form chloroform, then sodium formate. pure chloroform is obtained. Pure chloroform is obtained from this particular method. Third one, from carbonyl compound, from carbonyl compound with methyl ketonic group. Which group? Methyl ketonic group. Now this is CH3, C double bond O CH3. When reactivate, chlorine in presence of sodium hydroxide, this particular reaction is known as haloform reaction. Haloform reaction. It forms CaCl3 plus sodium acetate. Sodium acetate. When acetaldehyde react with iodine in presence of sodium hydroxide, iodine in presence of sodium hydroxide to form iodoform plus sodium formate. This is chloroform. Below one is what? Iodoform. Above one is white color. Iodoform is which color? Above one is white color. Below one is which color? White color. Yellow color PPT. Which color PPT? Yellow color PPT. Yellow color PPT. Phenol react with chloroform in presence of aqueous potassium hydroxide. This particular reaction is known as Riemann-Thiemann reaction to form ortho-hydroxybenzaldehyde and para-hydroxybenzaldehyde. Second one is aniline react with our primary amine, especially aniline. Aniline react with chloroform in presence of alcoholic potassium hydroxide. This particular reaction is known as carbyl amine reaction. Carbyl amine reaction to form phenyl isocyanide phenyl isocyanide. It is a pole order. Which order compound? Pole order compound. In above two reactions, the involved electrophile is dichlorocarbene. it is an electrophile. Neutral electrophile is involved. This is neutral electrophile known as dichlorocarbene. Dichlorocarbene. That is DDT powder or DDT. It is commonly abbreviated as dichlorodiphenyl, trichloroethane, okay. It is used as a insecticide as well as fungicide in agriculture industry, or it is mainly used for the killing of which one? Mosquitoes. Trichloroacetaldehyde react with 2 moles of chlorobenzene. 2 moles of chlorobenzene in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Here is chlorine, CH, CCl3. Just loss of water molecule takes place to form this particular compound known as DDT. Okay, what is that? DDT. It is used as a insecticide. When zinc react, chloroform react with zinc in presence of hydrochloric acid to form dichloromethane. This is known as dichloromethane. Dichloromethane. Next one is, when chloroform react with zinc in presence of water to form which gas? Methane gas. The chloroform react with acetone to form chloritone. It act as a hypnotic drug. This chloroform react with aerial oxygen to form a poisonous gas, that is carbonyl chloride or poxine. It is a poison. Which one it is? Poison plus hydrochloric acid. Okay, so impure chloroform plus silver nitrate to form a white color precipitate. So due to the formation of this particular reaction, to remove poxine, ethyl alcohol is added. So therefore, that is immediately Cl, C double bond O, Cl, then 2 moles of ethyl alcohol to form diethyl carbonate. What is that? Diethyl carbonate, C2H5, oxygen, C double bond O, oxygen, then C2H5. This is known as diethyl carbonate. So due to formation of this particular reaction, so poxine is removed while adding which one? An alcohol. Okay, so these are the some of the important reactions which are related to which one? Chloroform. First one is, number one is nitration. Nitration. When chloroform react with concentrated nitric acid, loss of water molecule takes place to form Cl, here is Cl, this is known as trichloronitromethane. Trichloronitromethane this is commonly known as chloropicrine. It is mainly used in, it is act as a tear gas. Which gas? Tear gas. Which gas it is? Tear gas. To remove porzine, ethyl alcohol is added, or ethyl alcohol is mixed with chloroform to form diethyl carbonate. It is easily soluble in water.